Welcome to this brief guide on how to use the DGET formula in Excel. Are you ready to unlock a powerful Excel function that will make data retrieval a breeze? You can forget those complex VLOOKUP nightmares that often leave you lost in a maze of nested functions and potential errors. Today, we're conquering data with the elegant and simple DGET function. We'll build a dynamic search table that automatically updates employee information with just a click. Get ready to become a DGET master. Every great performance needs a well-prepared stage, and data analysis is no exception. So let's start by setting up our spreadsheet. Here we have a sample employee database packed with valuable information. Unique employee IDs, full names, job titles, departments, salaries, bonus percentages, and more. Our goal is to create a dynamic search table at the top of this spreadsheet to quickly find specific employee details, without having to manually search through hundreds of rows. Start by going ahead and inserting a few blank rows above your data. This space will become the control center for our powerful search table. Now, let's make sure you have the labels that will act as our search criteria. In row 1, you can see that I'm starting here with employee ID, full name, job title, annual salary, and lastly, bonus percentage. It's crucial to use the exact column names from your main data array. This ensures that DGET knows precisely where to find the information. Imagine having to manually type in each employee ID though in order to find an employee. That's not super efficient, right? So let's start by creating a user-friendly drop-down list to simplify our search. Select cell B2, where we'll input our employee ID. Head on over to the Data tab in the ribbon and select the option for data validation. This handy tool lets us control what kind of data can be entered into a cell. In the Allow list, choose List. This allows us to create a drop-down menu of all of the valid entries. Now we need to tell Excel what values to include in our drop-down. In the Source box, click the Range Selection icon and highlight all of the employee IDs in your database. That's B6 all the way down to B1005 for us here. This range includes all of the possible employee IDs that we might want to search for. Click OK and voila! We have a convenient drop-down list that lets us effortlessly choose any employee ID. Now for the star of the show, the DGET function. Select cell C2, which is where we want to see the employee's full name. Type in equals DGET and an open parentheses to begin building our formula. As you can see here in the tooltip, DGET needs 3 key pieces of information called arguments: database, field, and criteria. Let's think of these as the instructions for DGET. Firstly, it's where to look, then it's what to look for, and then it's lastly, how to find it. The first instruction is the database, which is the entire range containing all of the employee information. Click into your table and highlight your entire data array. To make sure this range doesn't change when we copy the formula later, we'll press F4 on our keyboard. You'll see that this adds dollar signs to the range, which makes it an absolute reference, a fixed point in our spreadsheet. Now for the field, the specific data that we want to retrieve. Type in a comma, and then instead of typing full name directly, we can simply select cell C1, which contains the full name header. By referencing this cell, our formula becomes super flexible, as we'll see in just a few moments. Finally, we define the criteria, or the search conditions. Type a comma and select cells B1 and B2 and be sure to hit F4 to make them absolute. This range includes the employee ID header and the cell with our drop-down list. By selecting this range, we're telling DGET, hey, find the row where the value in the employee ID column matches the employee ID we've chosen in the dropdown. Then simply close the parenthesis and hit enter, and there it is. The employee's full name magically appears. Now here's where the magic of referencing the header cell and locking our ranges comes into play. Instead of needing to copy and paste the formula and then edit it into these other cells, we can simply click and hold on the small square at the bottom right of cell C2 and drag it across to D2, E2, and F2. Notice how Excel automatically adjusts the field reference in each formula, pulling the corresponding data from job title, annual salary, and bonus percentage columns. And because we made our database range an absolute reference with those dollar signs, it stays the same in each and every formula, ensuring we always are looking at the correct data. And as you can see here, we can select a different employee ID from the dropdown, and boom, all the information in our search table updates instantly. This is DGET efficiency at its best. Drag, drop, and done. Don't be afraid to experiment with it. Try choosing various search terms and watch as your information updates in real time. You could even create new criteria tables based on other fields like the job title. So you could then type job title into a blank cell, then enter the specific job title below it. Simply modify your DGET formula to reference this new criteria table, and DGET will retrieve data based on your new search condition. And congratulations, you've now mastered the DGET function and built a dynamic search table. You can officially say goodbye to complicated formulas and hello to easy, efficient data retrieval. Go forth and conquer your data with confidence. Don't forget, you can always create a dropdown using data validation, which is available under the Data tab in Excel. Happy data hunting, and I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel. And if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.